Hello.
So today we have another job. It's an Asus laptop. Which is not working. Is not powering on at all. At least that's the customer say. And first I have to clean it because it's kind of dirty. Now begin to looking very a lot nicer. I hated to begin working at a dirty laptop or no matter what device it is. If it's not cleaned, I hate it. Actually, this laptop don't have any rubber in here, and because of that it's sleeping, so I put this trusty worn piece of this material. This is a very old model. It's an Asus X51R. It's very old, but customer is doing his job with him. This laptop was open before because you see he put a longer screw here, and that's why this inflate puncture appears here. You see this and this. Because screw is more longer and going through the plastic, but that's it. Okay, I not try to powering up before starting the video, but I'll do it now. And okay, we have signed. You see? It's charging the battery. Of course, battery is dead, very dead. Let's see. Okay. We have light here. We have an SSD, square SSD CD. It's the original one. But we don't have picture. Or we have a dead lamp. No, we don't have picture at all. And even the hard drive LED is not lighting up. Okay, let's try another. And now it's not powering enough. No. Okay, so after I put the power adapter, only one time react to pressing power button. After that, dead. No. Let's see what tension we have. Okay, almost 1.9 volts, which is good, and it's stable, is not floating, which is also good. Okay, so the power adapter is not guilty one. Let's take out the battery and try another. Okay, LED is light and no sign. No sign. So we have to take out and see what's inside. I'll stop the video because I have another job to do. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. First, I have to take out this lid. Here we have CPU and SODIMM. Okay, that's it. But here we have a hole to reset. Let's see. Don't have battery. We press 10 minutes. Okay. And let's see. Power on. LED is lit. CD-ROM drive is checking if it has some disk inside, but no sign of on the screen. No sign. Okay. So just taking out the hard drive also. the screw are the same. Yeah, we have dust. Very dusty inside. I remember at this model keyboard is not protected very well beneath she, and in those 10 or 12 or more, or maybe more than 12 years, some liquid can go on the main board and do some provide some oxide. We have here, and you see here, that's a rust. Okay, so I am more than sure that on the main board we're gonna find oxide, and that's why this laptop does not powering on anymore. But let's see, we only take out the RAM and put it back. Let's see. Yeah, no sign. But let me use another dim, another so dim. It's on the Dendre 2, and let's use another. Also another power adapter to be sure there's not a problem. I think this one is good. Okay, I take a way bigger adapter, but this is not a problem. This one is for it deliver 6.32 amps, and take out this dim, do some cleaning. this DIMM it's only 512 megabyte, but it's marked that it's a functional one. I use at test. Let's see. Green light and nada. So let's take out the fan. Dusty. This CPU was open before because this seal is broken. So this means that he is not having anymore the original thermal paste. Yeah. But the previous guy don't even cleaned the original paste. I don't know what they think. How big is the effort to clean best. Of course, this is the first the original paste, and it's a very stiffed thermal paste, but you see, but you know that guy, the proprietor came to you to clean it, not to make a bad job. So I heating up a little bit to clean it easy. This is Intel T2130 at 1.86 GHz. Okay, so now it's nicely clean. Let me do some powerful air flow. I feel it, the heat going to the going to the tube. Okay, so this is a perfect cleaned radiator. Okay, that's how a clean is doing good. Okay, so explain that I put a lot of isopropylic alcohol on the CPU and open and close it a few times to clean very good the contact. Okay. Because at this age contact become very dusty. So I feel that CPU is heating up, but screen it's off. I use I have to use this radiator, only radiator it's enough, and only two screw. And no change, okay? No change. So I'm sure that the problem is that I already said to you at the beginning that motherboard has on her some oxide. And for that we have to fully disassemble the laptop. Of dust. See? I marked that those they are a longer screw. This one, they are shorter. Okay, and now the screw from the back side of the laptop. They are all the same, only two of them. From here they are a little not slim version, so all screw they are slimmest. And only two, they are this one, more fatter, okay, in this position, not this, in this, because they are going into the metal hinge, and in that area you need to have more powerful screw. Let's see. No, sorry. So not this one. This one. This one from outside of the laptop, and this one. They are in this one. They are more fatter. Okay. And those cups. Let's see. Let's check if you have take out all the screw. Okay. And this model, you see, we have another two here and another two here, because here are the two connectors from the VDS and inverter and camera. So these are shorter screw, yeah. Okay, so you see, here we have wireless. And leave it this and the other the other stuff from the lid. So here we have two screw. They are making ground you see this one in to the left and one into the right and then fatter screw. And now take out in the opposition and that's it. That's the screen. Now we have another bunch of screw here. This model in particular, but kind of all older laptop, they have a lot of screw, you know. I think I have to take out the keyboard. We have some plastic here. Plastic clips into the up position of the keyboard and that's it. You see what I tell you? The keyboard from this model of the laptop don't have plastic here and all the just one drop of liquid going to the main board in this area or in this area or in this area and it's enough to create some oxide in time. Another bunch of screw. I don't have empty boxes anymore. Okay, that's it. take another photo for customer. I don't see any sign of oxide, but I'll use my lens and check it. And I see some sign of corrosion here. Okay, and kind of only in that area. Let's put this one in here. Take a photo. Let's use super macro. See? That's looking nasty. And let's see. I think in this area I see something. Yeah, I see another here. And another here. And another there. So three places. Okay, so let me take a photo. Which one, two, three? Those three. of. So on the VGA connection, okay, here those two cups in here and here, here at this resistor, and come on, I hate this. In this on the upper area at this cups, and I see it. Okay, I see it and in another area. At this chip, you see, here, they are making square circuit. Okay, so that's a lot of cleaning. I'll stop the video, I clean, and then I'll start with you to see if it's working. I'll be back. I don't know if this oxide I show you, but I think in this area and this one. You see? This resistor, this cups. It become a resistor because it's darken his color. So I use the original CPU and the original SODIMM, and I use the this one I don't have a webcam. So this cable is from even microphone don't have. So this one is from Levedes, from inverter. Okay. Okay, that's it. And we have this one is the power button. Let's put the original power adapter, and you see, let's see. And nada. So I have to dig more. I have to measure that CMD, that cups, to see what value it have there. And I'll get back to you. So the final problem was
this cups, it was here, a cups who going from brown color to black color. It has some resistor, some kind of 50 kilo ohms, okay. So it kind of lower the tension who go in this chip who go in the IT, and that's the problem. As I say to you at the beginning, you pay attention to all the oxide on the mainboard. So this is the one, okay. There are a lot of oxide on the mainboard. So I prove to you it's working after assembly back.
Was not cleaned before, so I clean. Is this is a version of fan who where do you can separate the fins apart the his structure, okay. So I use some oil and a very amount of DuraLube. I clean it best. Another picture for customer. And perfect. Like I say to you in previous videos,
always be careful not to press too much in the thing, in the fan, because you can break it or disconcentrate the vertical pin of the fan. So be gentle, okay? So first be careful at changing the CPU, yeah, and here and here we have a screw that are fattier than the rest of them. Deci, here and here, and here. Okay? Not this one, not this one, but both. They are more fattier than the rest of them. So, kind of like this. I have to call the customer to propose the making this laptop a little bit faster with an 7200 CPU and with 1 or maybe 2 giga of RAM in between these 2 gigabytes, because if he have Windows with 3 2 bytes, don't matter if he have 3 or 4 mega of RAM. I turn off because I have the keyboard. And again, at all laptops, it's better when you tearing apart, when you disassembly. It's better that you check the battery bars. Okay, this one have only 0.3 volts. Yeah, because I think it's the original one. I think, I don't know, but for sure it's very very old. Okay. ID, hard disk. Okay, we have a Hitachi with 160 gigabyte. Date, don't care. Okay, we can run off, boot, quiet and quick, first hard drive and then don't care, onboard LAN boot ROM disabled, mm. Okay, so save change and exit. Okay, fine, it's working. And hard drive working. And that's it. Okay. Was not cleaned before, so I clean. Is this is a version of fan who where do you can separate the fins apart the his structure. Okay. So I use some oil and a very amount of DuraLube. I clean it best. Another picture for customer. And perfect. Like I say to you in previous videos, always be careful not to press too much in the fin, in the fan, because you can break it or disconcentrated the vertical pin of the fan. So be gentle, okay? So first, be careful at changing the CPU, yeah. And here and here we have a screw that are fattier than the rest of them. Deci, here and here, and here. Okay, not this one, not this one, but both. They are more fattier than the rest of them. So kind of like this, I have to call the customer to propose the making this laptop a little bit faster with an 7200 CPU and with 1 or maybe 2 giga of RAM in between these 2 gigabyte, because if he have Windows with 3 2 bytes, don't matter if he have 3 or 4 mega of RAM. I turn off because I have the keyboard. And again, at all laptops, it's better when you tearing apart, when you disassembly, it's better that you check the battery bars. Okay, this one have only 0.3 volts. Yeah, because I think it's the original one. I think, I don't know, but for sure it's very old. Okay. IDE, hard disk. Okay, we have a Hitachi with 160 gigabyte. Date, don't care. Okay, we can run off. Boot, quiet and quick. First hard drive and then don't care. Onboard LAN boot ROM disabled. Okay, so save change and exit. Okay, fine, it's working. And hard drive working and that's it. Okay. So it sees the CPU T2130 at 1.86 GHz, and we have it sees 2 GB of RAM, and we have 32 bit operating system. So we only put another 1 GB because 2 GB don't care. That's it for now. Okay, so final step with the laptop. Now it sees T7200 CPU, and it's more powerful than original T2130. But memory RAM only accept 2 GB. If I put 2 of 2 or 2 and 1 gigabyte, only sees 2 gigabyte total. So that's it. Job done. Bye.